السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Today we will continue our talking about how to fill the self-study report for programs, part 2. If you are or didn't see the part 1, please refer to part 1 in order to know the important previous information that will help you to understand part 2. As you know, the part 2 of the self-study report for programs, it's talking about how to fill the standards, and we have here 6 standards as in the new forms of the NCAA. The first standards, as you see, it is standard number 1, which is about program management and quality assurance. In this standard, as we see, we have different criteria and we have 2 main parts. In the first part, we have program management, and in this part, we have 9 criteria, and part 2 is about program quality assurance, and we have here 3 criteria. In the first part, which is about the program management, we have 112, which is an essential criteria, and the second one is 118. It is also the second essential criteria in part 1, and in part 2 we have the 122, which is also an essential criteria, which means we have to focus on these 3 criteria in this standard and be careful to be sufficient and evaluated minimum with 3 and above, which means satisfactory substantial compliance. So in this criteria, which is about the management and the quality assurance, generally it's talking about how the program should implement an effective leadership and using the institutional systems, policies and regulations. And also it is about the program leadership, about planning, implementing, monitoring and activating the quality assurance system that will help the program to achieve its goals through the continuous development of the program performance in a framework of integrity, transparency, fairness and within a supportive organizational climate. If we look at these criteria, the criterion number 1, which is about the program mission and its goals, and that it should the program mission should be consistent with the mission of the institution or the college, and all and maybe and the college at the same time, and of course the mission should guide all the operations and activities in this program. Of course, to self-evaluation of the risk criteria and other programs, the committee, quality committee in the program or the department should collect enough evidence and also should provide operations and plans that support every criteria of for every standard, and based on this in these evidence and the reports should evaluate itself by 4 categories. The first one, non-compliance. I think nobody will choose this one, and the second, minimal compliance, and the third one, substantial compliance, and of course full compliance. Usually most of the programs they choose the substantial compliance, which is means that they have sufficient documents and sufficient activities to to cover or to meet this this criteria and the other criteria, of course. And in this case, they have the activities, they have the plans, they have the process, they have the evaluation and the development, but not in maybe in very high high quality. So in this case, most of programs, as I said before, they choose substantial competence. In order to know how to choose or to evaluate self-evaluation for every criteria, you can look to other my videos in this channel. I have already explained how to evaluate and how to put the scale. Of course, some they call it star scale or self-evaluation scale, but it is important and necessary to see my previous video about this. So we will not talk about the process of how to evaluate every criteria in this case, as you see, but you have to look that you have different elements of evaluation and you have different levels of evaluations, and you have when you fill every evaluate every elements based on these levels of evaluation, you have to be careful to have sufficient evidence and carefully choose the right level for evaluation. Regarding the essential criteria, as we said, in this standard we have three criteria. These criteria are very important, and if the quality committee or external reviewer or other accreditation bodies will see they are not sufficient, it will be lead to say or to judge this standard as non-compliance, and this is also will affect your final result of academic accreditation. So you have to read them carefully and look after every criterion so you have, as we said, sufficient evidence and documents to evaluate these elements. Let's go first to the first one, which talks about, as we said before, about the program mission and its goals, and they are should be consistent with the mission of the institution, college, and guide all its operations and activities. My advice in writing or to fill this standard is to follow these criteria one by one. You have to write the title for every chapter, we can say that, by this criterion, and based on this criterion you have to collect the needed evidence and to write to cover this or other criteria. If we look at the program mission and its goals, as you see, every program has its mission, and of course, based on this mission, all operations and all activities that should be provided in the department or in this program should be based on the mission, because they are the operations and activities in the by the end of the cycle. 4 years or 5 years should lead to achieve the program mission. And of course, because the program is a part of the college and the institution, the program should prove and to show that the program mission is consistent with the mission of the institution, the university, and the college, and it's based on the keywords of the mission and the keywords of the institution and the college. In a very simple way, the program can show that its mission consistent with the university and the college. For example, if the mission and most of the the missions and the programs. They are about a high quality of education, and they are about professionality, for example, and the community service and research. So each program should look at these keywords that should be, of course, in his mission, in its mission, in the mission of the institution, and in the mission of the college. And using some tables to show that they are consistent, and of course the achievement of the mission will lead to achieve the mission of the college, and finally the mission of the institution. Regarding the second criterion, which is about the program, if it has a sufficient number of qualified staff to perform its administrative, professional, and technical tasks, and they have defined tasks and authorities. This is an essential criteria, which is very important. And in order to meet this criterion also, as we said before, if you have a mission and you have operations and activities, in this we mean by operations and activities, of course, we have education, teaching students, we have administrative work, we have advising, we have laboratories, we have everything that we need to run, and of course to run these operations and activities we need a sufficient number of qualified staff to perform its administrative, professional, and technical task. In this case, we have to look carefully to have a specialized staff, teaching assistants, technicians, administrative staff that they can run, and you have to provide their a table of their names and their specializations, and of course their administrative work and tasks, and we can also provide information about the head of the department and the other committees that they are performed in order to run these operations and activities. The third one, 113, is if the program provides an organizational climate and supportive academic environment. In this case, it is not an essential criteria, but it is also important that the program should show that the environment in its program, that they are supporting the academic staff, they have provided them with all facilities, offices, medical help, medical insurance, parking, and the climate is very supportive, and they are all the administrative staff or the teaching staff, they are they are have a good climate, and they are supported by the program, and of course they you need to submit some evidence regarding this climate and to show them they are feel good in this program. Regarding the 114, which is that if the program management monitors the achievement of its goals through specific performance indicators and actions are taken for improvement, really this is very important, because we are, as you see, we are talking about standard about management of the program. Management of the program, which is very important, and leads that after management, you need to check if the result of management will give the results that or the program will achieve the goals and the objectives that has been put by it through checking these processes and results by the quality assurance system. So if we're talking about program management, we are talking about planning, about running of operations, and after that, through the quality assurance system or using the quality system, we will monitor and we will see if the operations and the activities, they meet the standards and they are running well, and of course they by the end they will lead to achieve the mission and the goals and objectives. So in the 114, the program management should monitor the achievement of its goals through specific performance indicators and actions are taken for improvement. As you know, there are for bachelor degree, we have 17 key performance indicators that specified by the NCAA, and these KPIs are distributed over different categories, some of them for students, some of them for teaching staff, for research, and they are distributed over what we call the six standards. So every standard has its own key performance indicators, and through these indicators and the results, we can evaluate and monitor if we achieved our goals or not. Really, the important thing here regarding the goals of the program, there are different goals. There are educational goals that we call program educational objectives or goals, and these goals, they are related directly to the students, and these KPIs, there are specific KPIs for program educational objectives, and there are some goals related to the program itself we call operational goals, and these goals, they are related to the research and community service of the program. They are not directly related to the students, but they are related to the activities and operations provided by the faculty member and the program to the society and the research. So usually the program education objectives has its key performance indicators. For example, if we are talking about the satisfactory of students, about the education, if we talk about the KPIs related to the performance or the graduates or related to the, for example, the skills of the knowledge of our students after graduation. We have some KPIs. They are related to the education of the program. But at the same time, there are some KPIs related to the operational goals. So, for example, we have some KPIs related to the research about the publication, number of publications, citations, and so on. So based on goals, educational or operational, they are directly related to our mission and the mission of the program. And as we know, the mission contains information, or we can say that it has educational and operational goals. And through these goals and through the performance indicators, we can measure the performance indicators and evaluate the results. And if we achieved our goals, we can say that we achieved our mission. Regarding the criterion number 115, the program management applies mechanism ensuring integrity, fairness, and equality in all its academic and administrative practices and between the male and female student sections and branches. Usually the program that doesn't have male and female students, they can ignore this criterion. But if you have male and females, they are not studying together, they are not in the same classroom, they are not using the same library, they are not using the same classrooms, they have different facilities. In this case, this criterion is very important, and you have to show that you have a mechanism. Using this mechanism, you should be sure that the integrity, the fairness, and the equality between the male and female, they are in a high level, and you have some practices to ensure that they are having the same facilities, the same education, the same labs, the same times for accessing library, for example, computers or something like this. So you have to show them that they have a sufficient number of faculty members for female and females, for example, other activities, for example, the activities that are not related to the education, for example, we extracurricular activities like sport activities or social activities. You have to show that you are really aware about the equality between male and female sections. Regarding the 116, it is about the program builds on the views of professionals and experts in the program specialization to contribute to its evaluation, development, and performance improvement. Really, every program at least has its what we call advising committee. This advising committee has number of members from the market, from education, from industry, and they are specialized and experts in this program specialization. For example, if it is about electrical engineering, they have to be professionals and experts in electrical engineering, mechanical, in medical, and in other specializations. And this the program tries to build based on their views and their feedback and their meetings to evaluate and development to enhance the performance of the program. And the program uses this feedback and these views to improve and to enhance the performance of the program. So in this case, I see that the feedback from the labor, from the maybe from the advisory, advising committee, from the graduates also, also from other specialized professionals, committees, engineering association, for example, medical associations, with they are responsible about engineering, about medical specializations, about nursing, about other specializations in the country. They can help with their feedback and to use their feedback to improve your program. In this case, you have to provide meetings, reports, and to show that you are already contacting these committees, these experts, and you have regular meeting with them, and in some cases you use their feedback, their views, in order to improve your program. And you can, for example, show them some of these feedback they were useful for your program, for example, to improve the training, to improve the mission, maybe, and to improve the curriculum of your program, and so on. Regarding the 117, the program management provides reliable and publicly disclosed information to the community about the program description, performance, and achievements that suits the needs of the stakeholders. The word stakeholders means all the persons that they benefit from your program, for example, students, faculty members, graduates, of course, they are graduated from your program, and of course the employers, and which is important. So I know that each program has some of surveys that they are directed to the graduated students, to the employers, to the faculty members, to the students, and they are collecting these the feedback from all of them. And at the same time, the program as in this criteria should provide them what is the program doing, what is its mission, what is its curriculum, the output of the program, number of graduates, all needed information should be published on the website of the program and in the website of the university, and all stakeholders should see this information that should be useful for them. I can give an example for students. You have to publish, for example, the course specifications, the curriculum, for example, the registration process, the exam regulations for faculty members, also the information that they need, their courses, their some of guides for them, information regarding their work, their duties and other things for the community. You can show them your, for example, number of graduates, the published, for example, papers, information about the program, its activities. So all these activities should, and this information should be published for the community and for a stakeholder to be useful for them, of course, including the mission, the objectives, the program learning outcomes, and so on. Of course, also the reports, the yearly reports, or for example, the annual program report, the other reports that can be useful to give, maybe we can say, more statistical information about the achievement of the program, or maybe some information regarding the achievements in some in conferences or in competitions that should be useful and to show the program achievement. The 118, which is an essential criterion about the program management, is committed to activating the values of scientific integrity, intellectual property rights, rules of ethical practices, and proper conduct in all academic research, administrative, and service fields and activity. Really, it is very important, essential criteria, and the program should have its regulations and mechanism that related to that, the rights and duties and the ethical practices and for and regarding the research, regarding the checking the similarity, regarding the funding, regarding the administrative and services that provided to the all who is working in this program should be clear, transparency, and also the rights of their rights should be clear for them, and should be explained, and should be monitored, and should be evaluated. So we are talking about services, and we are talking about rights and ethical practice that provided to the and of course for research in two ways: providing the services and check that all the practices that is the practices that have been done by faculty members or students, they are also monitored by the program using specific tools. Regarding the criteria number 119, the program management applies the systems, regulations, and procedures that are approved by the institution college, including those related to grievance, compliance, and disciplinary cases. There are different systems in every program. Maybe there is direct systems which were in this case the students, maybe they want to complain about the faculty members, they can go directly to the head of department, or they have some issues with teaching, or about some services. But in most universities there is an electronic program, or we can say a platform, that through this platform which can enable enable students to, or faculty members or administrative, that is about students only, they can submit their complaints, and if they have any cases that will keep their information secret and privacy will be granted for them, and they can deliver their grievance or complaints to the responsible person, because the responsible person may be at different levels. Maybe he is the head of department. If it is about the head of department, will be to the college, to the dean, maybe to the vice rector, or maybe higher. So the program should be sure that there is a clear mechanism, and there is a regulations that is published to the students, for example, to make them be free to complain, and as you see, approved by the institution and college, which means this process should be supported by the institution or the college to be above the program based on the level of the complaint from students or from faculty member or from administrative staff. In these 9 criteria, we are finishing the first part about program management, and we can conclude the following, that the program should have its own plans. In these plans, we have operations and activities that should be provided by the program, and these operations and activities they have should be based on the mission, and also these operation mission and activities should be of course be run by qualified faculty members and administrative staff, and after providing these activities and operations should be monitored and also should be evaluated. And as we see, in order to be sure that these operations and activities they are running in good way, some of criteria they are talking about how to monitor, how to develop and improve these activities by professional and experts, or also to monitor that they are going in a fair way, and all of them they know their rights and duties, and based on these specific mechanism, the program will be sure that all of these activities and operations they are controlled by the program. And when we talk about control, we are talking about management, and the management means that the head of department or the dean of the college or faculty members, every one of them knows his rights, his duties, his tasks, and know what to do, and know how to deliver these results of activities and operations from a low level to the other levels in very specific and smooth way. After that, in the second part, we are talking about the program quality assurance. The program quality assurance is a very important system, and the program management should implement an effective quality assurance and management system that is consistent with the institution quality system. This means that your quality management system should not be separated from the institution quality system, because as you know, the quality system of the program should be monitored and checked at different levels, from the program, the college, and the institution. And so in this case, the program should have or establish a very good quality system at program level to check all the quality operations and to be sure that these operations are done based on the standards and based on the plans, and they are in a very high quality, and based on the results the program can improve itself. And the quality system is very important, because the quality assurance, it is assured that all the operations and activities in the program, they are going under the same standards and the same regulations provided by the institution, and this will correct all the we can say the unwanted results that could be happen if the program haven't this quality assurance system. The second one, 2.2, the program analyzes the key performance indicators and evaluation data annually, and results are used in planning, development, and decision-making processes. Of course, we said we have plan. Based on the plan, we have activities. The activities based on some operations and activities, we are trying to achieve our plan. But how we can know if our activities or our plan is achieved? Because our plan is based on our goals, and our goals, they are based on our mission, and we want to know if we really achieved our mission and goals based on these activities. So all the activities in the plan should be connected or linked to a specific key performance indicators, and measuring these key performance indicators and compare them with the target that we put previously, we can really be sure if we achieved our goals and mission. And if we didn't achieve our target based on the key performance indicators, we need to make a development process. And also, based on these key performance indicators results, after evaluation, we can be sure we can make our decision. For example, if we have one key performance indicator about research, and our target was to publish, for example, one paper from every faculty member, and we didn't reach this target, this means that we have to make a decision and processes in order to enhance the performance of published research the next year. And also, maybe the decision will be to increase the fund. Maybe the decision will be, for example, to make other former or other activities in order to enhance the research publication numbers. So key performance indicators is an essential, and as I said before, we have 17 key performance indicators. They are distributed over all six standards, and we have to measure them for every standards and include the results and analysis of every key performance indicator in every standards in this SSRB, and also it is as required by the NCAA. One of the eligibility requirements is key performance indicators reports for the last 3 years, because based on them, the results of the key performance indicators, we can see the progress and improvement of the program, and we can see how is the quality of the program management, and how it used the results of the last three of key performance indicators evaluation results, how it used them to make a decision or take an action. For example, if the last three key performance indicator, which is about the number of students, they are very low, what action or decision they are made to increase the number of students. The last one, 1, 2, 3, the program conducts a periodic comprehensive evaluation and prepares plans for improvement and follows up its implementation. The planning can be in the beginning, and the planning can be also at the beginning of the next year based on the results of key performance indicators, because in this case we have actions, we have plan. As we said in 1, 2, 2, the program analyzes the key performance indicators and the evaluation data annually, and the results are used in planning. So we need a plan, annually plan, based on the key performance indicators, which show that the key performance indicators should be evaluated annually, every year. And for the next year, we have a plan, we have actions, we have activities, based on this comprehensive evaluation. And this, of course, this improvement plan should be monitored and followed by a specific quality committee or other committee to follow these activities that are included in these plans, to be sure they are implemented in the correct way and will lead to improve the program in the next year. This is about this standard about management and quality assurance system for this criteria. After that, as I said, you have to write in this program management talking about the first 9 criteria in the first part about program management. You have to write here, as I said before, you can make it simply for you. You can take, for example, this okay, you can, for example, take this criterion and put it here, and make copy and paste and make it your title, as you see. And after that, you can write everything regarding this criterion. You can write your mission, your goals, and to show them they are consistent with the mission of the student college. And you can provide evidence and reports to show that the program plans, the program activities and operation, they are related to the mission program. Writing here, after that, you can take the next criteria. Okay, you can go to the next criteria, criterion 112, make a copy here, and it will guide you to write the next. Okay, here. So now you are writing here about the program mission, you are writing here about the sufficient number of faculty staff, write for a list of your faculty members, their qualification, about the administrative staff and your technicians. You are writing about the defined task, about the task of the head of department, the task of committees, the form committees, what are the authorities of the head of department, what are the authorities for the vice deans, because they are also involved. You can write everything here. And of course, if you're writing something, you have to provide evidence or link to the evidence showing, for example, link showing to the, for example, the task, if they are published on the institution websites and so on. So this will be the best way to fill this standard, and you will not miss any information, and it will be smoothly and step by step. And the same you can do to the program quality assurance. Regarding the evaluation or overall evaluation for quality of standards, we have three types of evaluation that you have to write. The strengths, everything you think that strength, for example, you have high quality faculty members for all specializations and you cover all the fields of the program. The strength, you maybe you can write, for example, about your labs, about anything you see that in the program management you think it is a strength. Areas and priorities for improvement, maybe increasing number of students, increasing number of faculty members for female students. The action recommendation should be written based on the areas and priorities for improvement for the action recommendation. For example, to increase the number of faculty members for female students, and they will ask you what are the actions if it has been done. These actions for the course can be for the past and for the future. For example, we are in the process of hiring new faculty members. If the action about increasing the number of students, what is the action that you will do or have been done for the program to increase the number of students and so on. So you have to write your action recommendations here. Do not write anything is not real. Do not to rate yourself very high scale. Try to write the really real practices and operations for planning. If you have enough time in the future, you can of course write your plans and implement them in a very high quality. If you have already some problems with time and some issues related to some criteria not in sufficient way, you can write what is real and to show your plans for improvement in the future. But you have to concentrate on the essential criteria to be sufficient. And I think this is what all this is everything what I want to talk about this standard. See you in part three, inshallah. We will talk about the next standard, standard number two, which is a very long standard and very important standard, teaching and learning. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.